Hello friends, welcome to DDR Academy. Today I am discussing the image based questions, and it is important for the preparation for the nursing officer or staff nurse examinations. So first question, look at the picture and identify the device. Look at the picture and identify the device. The answer is supraglottic airways or laryngeal mask airway, or it is known as LMA. LMA means laryngeal mask airway. So what is supraglottic airways? They are group of airway devices that can be inserted into the pharynx to allow ventilation, oxygenation and administration of anesthetic gases without the need for endotracheal intubation. And laryngeal mask airway is also known as laryngeal mask. It is a medical device that keeps a patient's airway open during anesthesia or unconsciousness. And this laryngeal mask airway is a type of supraglottic airway. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the procedure. So what is the procedure, name of the procedure given in this picture? The answer is teletherapy. So teletherapy, also external beam radiotherapy. It is the most common. External beam radiotherapy is the most common form of radiotherapy, and teletherapy is defined as the radiation delivered from a distance through a linear accelerator. The linear accelerator produces photon beams with accelerated electrons from radioactive material for the production of external beam of gamma rays for treatment at a distance from the radioactive source. And the patient sits or lies on a couch, and the external source of ionizing radiation is pointed at a particular part of the body. So this is known as teletherapy or external beam radiotherapy. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the device. Answer is pulse oximeter. So what is pulse oximeter? It is a small lightweight device that is used to monitor the amount of oxygen carried in the body. This non-invasive tool attaches painlessly to the fingertip, sending two wavelengths of light through the finger to measure the pulse rate and how much oxygen is in blood. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the skin changes. What is a skin change given in this picture? Answer is keloids or hypertrophic scarring. So what is keloids or hypertrophic scarring? It is a raised scar after an injury has healed. It is caused by an excess of a protein called collagen in the skin during healing. And keloids are often lumpy or ridged. The scar rises after an injury or condition has healed, such as a surgical incision or acne, and they are usually not treated with medication. So this is mainly caused by the excess of collagen in the skin while the tissues are getting healed. Next question, look at the picture and identify the device. Answer is BiPAP and CPAP full face reusable mask. So non-invasive ventilation is the use of breathing support administered through a face mask, nasal mask or a helmet. Air usually with added oxygen is given through the mask under positive pressure. So this is BiPAP and CPAP full face reusable mask. Then next question. Look at the picture and identify the sign. Answer is Kernig's sign. Kernig's sign is given after Waldemar Kernig, a Russian neurologist. It is positive when the thigh is flexed at the hip and knee at 90 degree angles, and subsequent extension in the knee is painful. This may indicate subarachnoid hemorrhage or meningitis. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the device. Answer is defibrillator or manual external defibrillator. Defibrillation. It is a treatment for life-threatening cardiac dysrhythmias, specifically ventricular fibrillation and non-perfusing ventricular tachycardia. A defibrillator delivers a dose of electric current to the heart, and there are different types of defibrillator. First one is the manual external defibrillator, then manual internal defibrillator, automated external defibrillator, implantable cardioverter defibrillator, wearable cardioverter defibrillator, and internal defibrillator. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the fracture. Answer is impacted fracture. It is an impacted bone where bone is pushed into bone. An impacted fracture occurs when the broken ends of the bone are jammed together by the force of injury. It is an impacted bone where bone is pushed into the bone. Next question. Look at the picture and identify. Answer is urometer or urimeter. Urimeter is a sterile closed collection system with an integral measuring chamber. The vertical drainage system and incorporated non-return valves ensures the measuring chamber empties fully once the reading has been taken to ensure accurate measurements, especially with low urine output. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the sign. Answer is Gray Turner's sign. Gray Turner's sign refers to an uncommon subcutaneous manifestation of intra-abdominal pathology manifesting as ecchymosis or discoloration of the flank. Classically, it is associated with severe acute necrotizing pancreatitis, often in association with Cullen's sign, that is periumbilical ecchymosis. Next question. Look at the picture and name the fracture of the marked area. Answer is intertrochanteric fracture. Intertrochanteric fracture refers to a break in the continuity of femur between the greater and lesser trochanter, the bony prominence that lie outside the joint capsule. It is also referred to as extracapsular fracture. The head and neck of the proximal femur are within the acetabulum, and the fracture below the head of the femur, that is subcapital, or across the neck of the femur, transcervical, is referred to as intracapsular fracture. So this is intertrochanteric fracture or extracapsular fracture. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the newborn skin discoloration. Answer is Mongolian spot. Mongolian spot, it is a normal newborn skin variation, and this means the collection of pigmented cells that appears as slate gray patches across the sacrum, buttocks, and less commonly arms and legs of newborns. Mongolian spots are more likely to occur in newborn of Asian, South European, or African descent. They disappear by school age without treatment. They are not a result of injury or intestinal bleeding. Look at the picture and identify the line or catheter. Answer is peripherally inserted central catheter, PICC. PICC is inserted into the arm and terminates in the central circulation. It is used when medications or solutions are too caustic to be peripherally administered or when therapy lasts more than 2 weeks. Next, look at the picture and identify the chest abnormality. Answer is funnel chest. It is also known as pectus excavatum, funnel chest or pectus excavatum. It is caused by sternal retraction. It is a congenital chest wall deformity in which several ribs and the sternum grow abnormally, producing a concave or caved-in appearance in the anterior chest wall. It may be associated with genetic or connective tissue diseases. Next question. Look at the picture and identify the skin condition. Answer is seborrheic keratosis. Seborrheic keratosis is a benign pigmented lesion with a waxy surface on the face and trunk, as a waxy brown, black or tan growth. A seborrheic keratosis is one of the most common non-cancerous skin growth in older adults. It has multiple growths. Seborrheic keratosis often appears on the face, chest, shoulders or back. It has a waxy, scaly, slightly elevated appearance. So this is known as seborrheic keratosis. So thank you for watching the video. Also you can share this video to your friends. It's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire.